Hello, welcome to day 13 of Vlogmas. It is Tuesday and it is, what time is it? It is 2 o'clock. I've already had a full day. Up early, took my son to, he had to drop his car off to get serviced. And then I came home and started dyeing. I have all my minis dyed, almost dyed for those Valentine advents that I did. So that was a big job. And by the way, they're all gone. I'm sorry. People are asking if there's any more available. They're not. I only can make so many. So, but side note, I always do like an Easter advent. I call it my bunny box. So, I'll keep you updated on Instagram, I guess, when they're going to be available. So yeah, I get done dyeing and I just took a hot bubble bath because dyeing is so hard on my knees and back, just standing out in the garage. And oh, I'm just like, now I'm hot because I took a boiling hot bubble bath. So I wanted to go right in and just say, thanks for all the questions. I sat there and read them all. There were some really good questions. I don't know how Dan even narrowed it down to two, but I thought that I would kind of package up some of the questions and answer them all at once, because that was a question, if I would make content by answering. So I'm going to totally fly through some of these, and hopefully my answers encompass like two or three of your questions, and I hope I answer it all the information you were asking for. If I didn't hurt your comment on YouTube, it's because I'm going to answer it tomorrow. So I'll get right into it about Dan. Someone asked if he knits. He does not knit. And trust me, I have asked him if I could teach him, and he's like, no, I'm good. He used to sit at the ballpark like this with his hands, and like, so I could, if I bought yarn, I could ball it up at the ballpark, and I think that's his extent of his participation in knitting. And yes, I have knit him a sweater. I've talked about it before, but I'll show that within the next few days. Regarding his smoker, he did not buy a kit. He literally YouTubed it. Dan, he's an electrician now, but he used to be a welder, so he has all of that knowledge behind him. So when he welded the base, and he sourced out an old whiskey barrel for the actual smoker body, and then he welded everything that went inside. So yeah, he just kind of YouTubed a few things of some specifics that he had to find out, but no, he did that all by himself. It was not a kit. Someone asked what the rub was. This is the rub. And it's whiskey bent barbecue. I don't know where he got this, but so that. And then after he put the brown sugar and butter on the ribs, he wrapped them up and smoked them for another 3 hours, and then took them out and then just put some store-bought barbecue sauce on them and let them heat up again. Everybody loved them. They were a hit. What do I love about him? Dan is one of the kindest, nicest people in the whole wide world. My kids adore him. My family loves him. My friends. This whole meeting somebody in life later, it was a very natural, easy fit. He's my best friend in the whole wide world. And Mitch was also like the kindest person in the world as well. Like, so well loved. And I'm so lucky. I hit the jackpot twice with human beings to have as partners. So yeah, that's about Dan. Dying, a lot of dying questions. How did I learn? And why did I learn? I don't even remember. I think I just was buying so much yarn, and it just was, I was really attracted to hedgehog fibers, like the colors and the brightness. And I mean, hedgehog has some beautiful colorways, and I just wanted to try it. So I just started ordering some yarn, and then I found a wholesaler that if I was going to go for it, I was going to go for it, because you had to order so many pounds of yarn. And anyway, I went full throttle. It's same thing, YouTubed. You know, there was ideas on how to use citric acid or vinegar as your binding agent for the dye on the wool. I personally like citric acid. Yeah, I dye in my garage. Just Dan set me all up. He built like a whole station, and I use burners and pans. My colorway inspirations are, it's so random. It could be the time of year or food or a song. Sometimes I'm just playing with color. Some of my prettiest colorways that I find, you know, the most eye-catching have been mistakes, to be honest. You can aim for a certain thing and then something else happens. So that's always fun. And as for names, I name it before, usually. Like I have like something in mind, and it's usually a song or something crazy. I don't know. But my favorite thing about dyeing is I get to work at home doing something I actually do. I love it. Like it's so much fun. I love being creative. That's like, I've always been kind of an artsy fartsy person. And yeah, so this, it just makes sense that this is what I'm doing. My least favorite thing is it's actually starting to kill my back. Like I have like a mat down to stand on. Like it's in my concrete garage, and I wear great footwear, all of it, but I can't dye for long periods of time anymore, so I have stopped wholesaling. It's just I don't know, I have more fun doing it in small batches anyway, but yeah, so that's probably my least favorite, is just the toll I feel like it's on my body. Okay, my favorite knit item that I've ever made, and this might be surprising because I'm such a sweater knitter and I've done some, you know, beautiful color work and everything, but I'm going to show you my all-time favorite knit. It is the Campside shawl by Alicia Plummer, and I absolutely love this. Like this always goes on a trip with me. It's just something that I want if I'm on a plane or if I'm sleeping, I don't know, at someone's cottage, and I don't know, anything. Like I always have it with me. It's the shape of it, the yarn, I can't remember the yarn, I'm gonna have to ask Michelle. I bought it at Cricut Cove. Anyway, I have a colorway very similar that I named Blush, because this is my happy color. If my whole world could be this color, I would have it this way. Like I need to paint my front door this color. So it's just a whole bunch of yarn overs. It's such a nice size. So to wear it like this, I like wearing it just even like this. It's just everything about this I love. The size, the shape, the color. So this would be my all-time favorite project, and it's as simple as that. It's all about the color, the shape. It's a DK weight shawl, so you know, it knit up very quick. She also has a sweater in this kind of pattern as well. And yes, yeah, someone also asked, you know, what's my least favorite? I probably have a couple, but I have to think about it, and I'll dig them out to show you. I've given quite a few sweaters away that I'm just like, why did I knit this? And yeah, jump on the trend bandwagon maybe once too often. So anyway, so that's my favorite. What motivates me and keeps me happy and grounded? Honestly, I have amazing friends and family. Like I have the best friends in the whole wide world that are like family. My mom, my dad, my stepmother, or my stepfather, Mitch's parents, you know, Dan, the kids. Like I'm really surrounded by wonderful people, and that motivates me to clearly stay happy and healthy. And I guess even telling you what I told you yesterday is a bit of background on, you know, I haven't always been happy. Like I had a really bad period of, you know, finding my happiness again, but had to, because I had two little kids that I adore and they adored me. And we had to get back on track. So anyway, that's my friends and family. Where am I from? I'm from Fredericton, New Brunswick. That's on the east coast of Canada. Born and raised, I went to university here and everything. I moved away for 2 years. One of my girlfriends and I, we moved to Grand Cayman. Worked at a resort after I went to UMB. We took off for 2 years and worked at a resort, went scuba diving and partied for 2 years. So other than that, I came home and met Mitch probably within the year that I moved home. Yeah, we got married, had kids right away. So, and I love being in Fredericton. It's a good place to live. It's safe. It's beautiful. There's, you know, it's growing with restaurants, and we're actually known for a lot of breweries. So I've taken you to one, and I'll be taking you to more because, yeah, we like to go to breweries. And okay, last is someone asked me about hair products, and there I can kill two birds with one stone, so I can show you a product of the day and tell you about my hair products. I use Olaplex. I use the shampoo and conditioner, and then when it's wet, I use the Bond Smoother. Something else I just probably started using like maybe 3 months ago is this K18. It's a hair mask, and you shampoo your hair and you don't condition it. You get out of the shower, towel dry it, and then you put this in it. And it's been good. I have very dry hair. Like, I mean, I've got coarse, thick hair, but it's dry. So I do need to use masks and whatnot. But, and then a new one I just got is this Amika Dream Routine Overnight Hydration Treatment. And I haven't tried it yet, so I'll have to let you know about this, what I think about it. I haven't used it because when I read the instructions, you have to put it on damp hair and then go to bed. And I've been cold going to bed lately, so I don't want damp hair. Yeah. Anyway, I hope that was some information that answered some questions. And like I said, if I didn't hurt your comment on YouTube, it's because I'm yet to answer it. Yeah. So I'm going to go chill for a little bit, and then I'm going to get supper started. I'm going to show you what I'm making for supper. It's an easy recipe. It's with my Instant Pot that I found online years ago. And anyway, the kids both love it. Dan loves it. It's hearty, it's healthy, and it's quick. So I will get to that shortly. Yeah. Okay. Talk to you soon. Okay. I'm getting ready to make supper. So, yeah, if you want to grab a pen, I'm going to go over the ingredients. We're going to make Mexican chicken soup, and I'm using my Instant Pot. You don't need your Instant Pot, but if you have one, it's a nice, quick, easy meal. Found the recipe online years ago, so. Oh, here goes my son. He's in his room. Electric guitar. Okay, so here's your ingredients that you're going to need to make Mexican chicken soup. So I've got 2 chicken breasts and just chopped up. 2 cans of fire roasted like diced tomatoes. You need some enchilada sauce. I'm using the green just because it's medium heat for spiciness, but go ahead and use the red if you want. You need 2 cloves of garlic, some diced white onion, 1 cup of frozen corn, 1 can of green chilies, 1 can of black beans that you're gonna drain and rinse, 1 box of chicken broth, and then your seasonings are cumin, chili pepper, and paprika. I don't really have any measurements, just I know these seasonings tend to pack some punch, so whatever your taste buds like, I just kind of eyeball it. So I will now do a video of the process, and the instructions will be on the screen.